In this study, we describe for the first time the effects of vitamin D on human colon normal and tumor fibroblasts and the association of vitamin D receptor expression in these cells with colorectal cancer patient survival. Colorectal cancer is a major health problem worldwide. Vitamin D deficiency is associated with high colorectal cancer incidence and mortality, suggesting a protective effect of vitamin D against this disease. The most active vitamin D metabolite, 1-alpha-25-dehydroxyvitamin D3, also known as calcitriol, has antitumor effects on cultured colon carcinoma cells by inhibiting their proliferation and promoting their differentiation, and also in several animal models for colorectal cancer. However, we and others have reported that vitamin D receptor, VDR, is downregulated in carcinoma cells in a proportion of human colon tumors, which may limit the applicability of VDR agonist for the treatment of this neoplasia. Given the strong influence of tumor stroma on cancer progression, and in particular several recent reports indicating that stromal fibroblasts contribute to poor prognosis in colorectal cancer, we investigated VDR expression and the potential effects of calcitriol on colorectal cancer stroma. First, expression of vitamin D receptor was analyzed in primary tumors of 658 colorectal cancer patients. We found that VDR expression in carcinoma and stroma of primary tumor compartments differed among patients. 14% showed high VDR levels in both compartments. 11% displayed high VDR in carcinoma cells and low in stroma. 13% presented high VDR in stroma and low in carcinoma. And 61% had low VDR in both compartments. Interestingly, we observed that high VDR expression in tumor stromal fibroblasts was significantly associated with increased overall and progression-free survival of colorectal cancer patients. Moreover, multivariate Cox regression analysis indicated that VDR expression in these cells was an independent predictor for overall survival. These results led us to examine calcitriol action on stromal fibroblasts. To this end, we established primary cultures of human, normal, and cancer-associated fibroblasts from fresh tumor tissue and paired normal colon mucosa from colorectal cancer patients by using the explant outgrowth technique. We found that both types of fibroblasts express VDR and respond to calcitriol. Remarkably, calcitriol inhibits the protumoral activation of normal and cancer-associated fibroblasts. It reduces their capacity to contract collagen gels and also their promigratory action on colon carcinoma cells. Moreover, calcitriol modulates the gene expression program in normal and cancer-associated fibroblasts, regulating a large number of genes involved in several crucial tumor-related functions. Importantly, calcitriol imposes in cancer-associated fibroblasts a gene signature that predicts a favorable clinical outcome in colorectal cancer patients. In summary, our data indicate that expression of VDR and calcitriol-associated gene signature in tumor stromal fibroblasts predicts a favorable clinical outcome in colorectal cancer. We propose that calcitriol exerts its antitumor action in this neoplasia, not only by acting on carcinoma cells, but also through the inhibition of the protumoral capacities of stromal fibroblasts. Thus, the therapeutic action of VDR agonists may extend to colorectal cancer patients who express VDR in tumor stromal fibroblasts, even in the absence of VDR expression in carcinoma cells. In conclusion, VDR agonists could be explored as a therapy against tumor-activated stroma.